1:45 a.m. Wonga, Hong Kong. This is not the line to a concert or testing clinic, but to a newsstand selling the final edition of Apple Daily, Hong Kong's last remaining pro-democracy newspaper that was reportedly pressured to stop printing by Beijing. Chinese government mouthpiece The Global Times wrote of Apple Daily that the outlet has greatly exceeded the information function of the media and turned into a political revolt seeker, adding any media outlet that has gained inciting power to oppose the mainstream will not be spared.
Well, it's profoundly sad. The media group that's there, they're closing down, was founded by Jimmy Lai, who was himself, like so many people in Hong Kong, a refugee from the brutalities and the repression of the Chinese Communist Party in China itself.
All 1 million copies of the Apple Daily were snapped up by 8:30 a.m. This wellspring of support read as a symbol of Hong Kong's resentment towards the Chinese Communist Party. With the closure of Apple Daily, the US and UK remarked on the loss of freedom of expression in Hong Kong, saying it was forced by intensifying repression from Beijing. So what's behind this growing crackdown on dissent? He pledged to improve China's human rights record, but when President Xi Jinping rose to power in 2012, the crackdown is said to have escalated. This graph from the Wall Street Journal shows expenditure on public security has nearly doubled since the beginning of Xi's presidency. In 2013, a leaked internal communication known as Document No. 9 warned against promoting false ideological trends such as press freedom and constitutional democracy. This Thursday, China will mark 100 years since the establishment of the CCP, managing to avoid the fate of many Eastern European Communist parties and the Soviet Union.
The relentless sweep of communism.
It is now at a position of unchallengeable power. Some dissenting scholars in Beijing say it's now looking to establish historical legitimacy. So if perfectibility breaks on the rock of dissent, China will stop at no end to ensure its citizens are surveilled and the critics among them silenced. This is what social control in the digital age looks like. It's called a social credit system and is taking shape in China.
Facial recognition, body scanning and geo-tracking, matched with your personal data and online behaviour, will power the social credit system.
The behaviour of every citizen is watched and scored. ProPublica and the New York Times say these videos, among thousands of others, are proof of propaganda. Cogs in a well-oiled machine designed to keep the CCP in power for another century. Conor Alforque, 6 News.